about a people, my people, who were down many times in our 400 years of struggle for justice. But we refused to let our enemies have the last word. Because we must remember the cross comes before the resurrection. And today may be your cross, but tomorrow you will be resurrected.
I was born into a system constructed for power, a machine well oiled, the pumps hate by the hour. A barren wasteland in desperate need of a shower, but its process refined like an addictive white powder. But if we're not present, does a tree make a sound? If we don't stand up, who's gonna stand the ground? If we don't call bullshit on the madness all around, then we deserve what we get. You see, the system that we have is not a system that is broken. It hides behind the curtain, hoping you won't look and discover that the man who is pulling the levers is fat and happy and not remotely clever. But 400 years of insistence, he deserves it, produces our resistance in the people he's been hurting. The facts and the stories are beyond dispute, and so I ask the question. If Howard Thurman's right, and to alter the equation, guys like me need to forfeit what I'm saving and throw myself on the mercy of God and beg Michael Brown's mom to forgive my wrongs. Am I willing to give up my security to let go of the things that I hold dear to me? Am I willing to sacrifice my life to help a young black man live another day?
Lift every voice and sing.
Number one, listen to the one who's been followed and mocked and shunned and stopped for no other reason than the color of her skin, answering questions about where she's been. Step number two, admit that it's you who benefits daily from your lack of melanin. And if you're not questioning the privilege you're enjoying, then let me make clear that you are living in sin, because a black man dies every 28 hours, 21 times the rate at the hands of the powers than a white man does. It's not clear to me how you can't see that that's a travesty. This is not just a game that we are playing. Vegas isn't listing any odds that they are laying. This is a fight for the soul of America. This is a fight for the soul of the here and now. So will you join me in a call for justice? Will you rise up and cause a big ruckus? Will you sing of hope and expectation? Today is the cross, but tomorrow resurrection.
Concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over and I've seen the promised land.